Let's pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you. King of glory, we thank you. We bless your holy name for this great day today, bringing us together again to remind us your word, to prepare us for your coming. Thank you, Jesus. Holy Spirit of God, come and take control. Use me as a vessel to speak to me and each one of us. Anyone that will come across this message, oh God, I pray that his life will never remain the same again. I cover this teaching in the mighty blood of Jesus. In Jesus' name, amen. Hallelujah. Let's mute our mic. We are before the Lord. I greet you all in the name of Jesus. This is Evangelist Claire Andun Atongo. Some people are still, I'm still hearing noise there. Praise the Lord. Okay. The title of the message today. Heavily minded or dangerously distracted. Heavily minded or dangerously distracted. What I'm hearing today among Christian is, time is short, oh. Jesus is coming, oh. We don't have time, oh. It's near. It's coming. I'm hearing it now and days. And it has become something like a laughing matter again. People does not take it serious. Jesus, come. Jesus is coming. Jesus is coming. Jesus is coming. Do you know that we are in the end time now? Do you know that is the message everybody is saying today? But are you saying it with all? Do you know what you are saying? Do you really know what you are saying? The Bible says in the book of Matthew chapter 24, verse 42, it says, watch, let's open. Matthew chapter 24, verse 42. Watch therefore, for ye know not what hour your Lord doth come. We know the hour has come. The time is up. Time is so short. We all know. You know. I know. You are even saying it every day. Jesus is coming. Jesus is coming. Jesus is coming. Jesus is coming. Morning, I'm hearing it every day, every day, every day. And we know that the time we are going now are the last days. The Bible says it in the book of 2 Timothy chapter 3. The Bible talk about the perilous time. These are the perilous time. We are living the last days. We are probably the last generation. I'm not saying I'm sure, but 50% or 60%. When we are looking at the hour, we can say we are the last generation. So the day of the Lord is coming. The day of the Lord is almost there. And everybody know, even children, they know something is wrong. Even unbelievers, they know that something is wrong. They know there is something that will soon happen. How? They can't explain. And every believer up and down, you know, hey, somebody called me. A brother called me from Africa. He says, Sister Claire, I want a wife. I want a wife. My wife must come in the virtuous woman there. My wife, I say, my brother, pray. Pray, God will reveal you your wife. My wife is coming there, Sister Claire. It is there. My wife will come. Because I need to get married. Queen Jesus is coming. I don't know how many years. You understand? So he knows Jesus is coming, and he wants to get married quick. He said he wants to enjoy the marriage before Jesus comes. Some people know Jesus is coming, and they are doing things fast, 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 fast. Now, the day of the Lord will come. So many of us will be celebrating birthday. Some of us will be celebrating, preparing, you know, trying to realize their project, long-term project. Some of them will be at the edge of success. Jesus will come when you are at the edge. You are at the edge of success. Jesus will come when you are, maybe your wedding is tomorrow. Some of them will come when your wedding is about to happen today. Maybe when they are pronouncing you husband and wife, Jesus will come there. Do you understand? Jesus will come when some of us are preparing for our exams. Jesus will come when some of us are doing the exams. Or maybe some of us are receiving our graduation. Jesus will come in a time, you know, we don't know. Some of us will be doing evangelism. Some of us will be praying here on Zoom. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Some of us will be doing other things, resting. Some of us will be in the kitchen. Some of us will be at the bed with our husbands. Some of them will be doing other things. But Jesus will come. He will definitely come. He said, we don't know that day. We don't know the hour. The day of the Lord, in the book of 2 Timothy chapter 3, verse 10 to 13. The day of the Lord. Let's read. The day of the Lord. The day of the Lord will come as a thief in the night. Amen. 2 Peter chapter 3, verse 10. It said, but the day of the Lord will come as a thief in the night, and in the which the heaven shall pass away with a great noise, and the element shall melt with fervent heat. The earth also and the works that are therein shall be burned up. Hallelujah. So the day of the Lord shall come as a thief of the night. The day will come when you are not expecting. It means that the coming of the Messiah will come at an hour that many of us are not expecting. Maybe that day is a great day for the space, like birthday, where you have invited so many people in the house. You know, the pastor is there. People are praying. They are ready to eat eba. They are ready to eat obono. They are ready to eat jollof rice. They are ready. You understand? And your mind is far. You don't even imagine that is the hour. Some of us are pregnant. Will be pregnant, waiting to see their baby. You know, preparing for the baby to come. Let's mute our mic. Fabiola, mute your mic. Preparing for the coming of the baby. You know, some will be in the labor. Fabiola, mute your mic. Mute your mic. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Some of us will be in labor. Many women in labor. You know, you will be doing something. And here, everybody wants to realize his project. You have a project. Maybe your project is to build a big factory that will be producing something that will help the community. You know, that is your project and you are working on it. You are praying that before Jesus comes, that project is realized. You know, somebody like me, the Lord has given me a vision. My prayer is that before Jesus comes, that vision has been fulfilled. You, maybe, I don't know about you. Your vision is maybe to do something. That's something. You are preparing for it. You know, everyone wants to realize his project before the coming of Jesus. But that will not stop the coming of Jesus. That will not stop the coming of the Messiah. That will not stop Jesus to come on the hour he has prepared to come. Jesus might come before your project come to pass. Let me tell you, some people say Jesus cannot come now because he's the one that gave me this vision. And he has not yet been fulfilled. He can't come now. No. One day I was thinking like that. A voice spoke to me. He said, Claire, remember the word of God. He said, you don't know the hour. You don't know the hour. Get ready all the time. Every minute. Jesus Christ can come before you realize that project. Jesus Christ can call you this hour today in the morning. You can have an encounter with the Lord. He said, go and preach my word. I will use you all over the world. And that very afternoon, Jesus come. I am telling you. Yes. Your project will not stop the coming of the Messiah. Your vision will not stop the coming of the Messiah. As I said, Jesus Christ can call you in the morning and come in the evening. Now, my question to you, are you a heavenly minded or you are dangerously distracted towards your project or towards heaven? You know Jesus is coming. Are you a heavenly minded or you are dangerously distracted? Praise the Lord. Whatever you do here on earth, I want you to know that you are living the last days. You are living the last days. The last day means the remaining days. The last day means the last hour. Praise the Lord. The remaining hours you still have here on earth, the extra days. How are you living these extra days? You already know that Jesus Christ is coming. And how are you preparing it? Are you heavenly minded or you are dangerously distracted? I sent a message to the people and said the enemy has released a spirit of distraction upon the children of God. So that the children of God at this hour, these last days, this last hour, these remaining days, these remaining hours, for us to prepare ourselves for heaven, Satan wants to use it for other things. He has released a spirit of distraction upon the children of God. Who unto him that will fall into the trap of the enemy? I want you to know that we are living the last hour. Praise the Lord. The aim of the enemy is that instead of you to be focused on heaven, Satan wants to take away your mind and you begin to be focused on the things, on your project. Praise the Lord. Things that will pass away. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Now, how are you preparing yourself for the coming of Jesus? In these last days, my sister, my question to you, how are you living the remaining days? How are you living your remaining days? How are you living your last hour? How do you value your last time? How do you value your time? How are you sure that you will realize what you are planning for the next 5 years? Because you know we are living a dangerous, perilous days. You know we are living the last hour. Now, my question to you, how are you managing your time? Are you heavenly minded or you are dangerously distracted? That is my question to you. Are you busy for the things of God? Or you are busy for the things of the earth? Are you dangerously distracted? Or you are busy for the things of heaven? How do you prepare yourself? Virtuous woman, how do you prepare yourself? How? In your time. In your daily life, let's say Jesus is coming on Monday. How is your Monday? How do you prepare your day? What if Jesus come on Wednesday, maybe on Thursday or Tuesday when there is no Bible study, when you are busy doing other things? Those remaining times for us here on earth, for you here on earth, how do you spend them? Are you dangerously distracted? Or are you heavily minded? That is the question the Lord wants us to ask ourselves today. How do you prepare yourself in your daily activities? Okay, that project you are projecting for, maybe that your work. How do you impact Jesus Christ in your daily life? You have a great project coming in the next 1 year. How do you prepare that project? Making sure that project do not block you for heaven. I don't know if you get me. You are focused on that project, but you are making sure that heaven do not block you. That project do not block your heaven. So how are you combining the two? Are you heavenly minded even when you are busy doing your work, or are you dangerously distracted? How are you preparing, my sister? How do you prepare yourself as a virtuous woman in your home, knowing that very soon we'll all appear before the throne of the Most High God and will be judged according to what? Every works that we have done here on earth. You will be judged based on your actions and character in your marital life. Virtuous woman. So, how do you know that whatever you do at home, on that day, God they will open it like that? Now, many women, we forget that. We forget that whatever we do in our kitchen, in our room, in our sitting rooms, whatever we are doing is we decide whether we will make heaven or not. How are you packaging your daily life? And how are you preparing your heaven? Are you dangerously distracted, or are you heavily minded in your daily life, in your home? Virtuous women. Because many times we say we are so busy, and truly, if you see, many women are busy for nothing. Busy for nothing. In the society, what you are doing in the society, in the community, in the church, how do you prepare yourself? How do you prepare yourself with all your daily activity in the church? How do you prepare for the sudden coming of the Messiah? Because God will come suddenly. He will come suddenly. He will make sure that He comes suddenly. Now, how do you prepare yourself? What Jesus come now? How do you prepare yourself? Are you sure you will be raptured? You must make sure that you will be raptured. That is why I want us to not come back to our daily. How do we manage our daily time? It is not. Some people say, I pray. I used to pray. I say, Jesus must come on Sunday. Jesus must come when I finish to preach like that. Or maybe death must come when I finish to preach. When I finish like this, I just go and sleep. Death must come. But let me tell you, my dear sister, death will come in a time that you don't expect. Jesus will come in a time that we don't expect. Now, how are you preparing it? Sister, heaven is something that we must not joke. The last day remaining here on earth, the last hour, let us program it. Praise the Lord. Program it. See, the people of the earth, people that are working in the administration, whatever they do has time. They have a timetable. How much more us, we children of God, women, let us begin to work on our timetable. Time is too short. Work on your timetable so that the day of the Lord will not surprise you, virtuous women. Yes. How are you preparing it? Somebody can be preparing. Someone can be preparing for his graduation. But in the meantime, it's devoted to God. You can be preparing for your wedding. You can be preparing for your project. You can be preparing for many things. But in the same time, you are devoted to God. But some people, some Christians, can be preparing for other things. For this thing, this project, but they are dangerously distracted for the things of God. And they think that they are still on the way when they have already backslided. Somebody can be busy with the things of God, but in reality, she is dangerously distracted. Yes. Somebody can be busy doing his work, but he is devoted. He is heavenly minded. His time is managed. He knows everything is in order. But you that is working for God, but you are out of God, you are dangerously distracted. Somebody can be busy for the things of God, but he's dangerously distracted. The Lord showed it to me one day. I was preaching the word of God, and the Lord spoke to me and said, you are distracted. Even in that preaching the word of God, you are distracted. I said, how come? Then the Lord began to explain to me. How are you managing the last remaining days, my dear sister? When we hear Jesus is coming, we are afraid. Yeah. You are afraid. What are you doing? The perilous days we are living today. They say perilous days. Those are the days that it takes the grace of God for you to be focused. Satan will do all he can. Don't allow anything to shake you. Good news, praise the Lord. I know a brother that likes to say praise the Lord all the time. If it's a good news, praise the Lord. A bad news, praise the Lord. You are unshakable. Hallelujah. Unshakable. Your mind is focused on heaven. Every day, every hour, every second. Praise the Lord. Now, I want to address to all the Facebook here. I believe everybody has Facebook here. All the Facebookers, Facebook ministers here. I know everybody here are ministers of God, because I see what you people are doing. You are bombarding the word of God. You know, people are commenting. Facebook ministers. Let me tell you that many of us are falling into the trap of the enemy. The enemy is using Facebook to distract so many ministers of God. In the time that you are forgetting your time, you are forgetting your life, you are just there. Who command again? One command. One like. How many like? I'm waiting for the third like. Third like. Okay. Then the enemy say, check other people. You begin to check. You check again. Satan is laughing. They say, minister of God, got you to check. You check. When the spirit of God say, come out of Facebook, the devil say, no, put another comment. You have not finished. Remember, you are a minister of God. You see, my sister, you are busy with the things of God, but you are dangerously distracted. I am telling you, if Jesus come that hour, you will not even know. You will just be hearing. Maybe you will see in that same Facebook, rapture has happened. Eh? When? They say 1 week ago, you will not even know. Maybe after 1 week, you will not even know that rapture has happened. Many ministers of God has fallen into this trap. Instead to be heavily minded, they are dangerously distracted. And that is how they are going to miss heaven in a big quantity. When they say only one person has made it, two persons, they say, how come? Hey! With the way you are living your times like this, 24 hours a day, you spend 15 hours on Facebook. 15 hours on Facebook. In fact, you are 24 hours on Facebook, because the way you've made it on your phone is this certificate you are there. And then even when you are praying, you are checking your Facebook. Some people are like that. They are like this. They will go to YouTube. The computer is full. YouTube is open. Facebook is open. This one is open. Like this is open. Then when you talk to them, I'm working for God. I'm praying. We are praying. You are busy, but you are busy with the things of God, but you are dangerously distracted. You are not managing your time. At this hour, my dear sister, we have to go back to our senses. Let's go back to our senses. Please. Are you heavily minded or you are dangerously distracted? This is the message. It is time for us virtuous women. Please, let us be. I am somebody, if there is no order in my life, I am disoriented. I don't know, is it disoriented or disoriented? Yes, I need timetable. Do a timetable. Did it, so from this time, 9 to 10, this is what I'm doing. Please, woman, let us do that. Set up alarm. Well, the technology of today is so good. Alarm of your phone. Time to pray. Time to memorize. Time to Facebook. You can say, okay, Facebook is 1 hour per day. Holy Spirit, before your time come, you pray before you open your Facebook. Father, my time to open the Facebook as a minister has come. I don't know what Satan has planned for me. Please, virtuous woman, this time is no more time to joke. Lord, I am going to do something on Facebook. I'm going to share messages. Do a program. I'm sharing messages like I'm working with my stampo. I will send her message on WhatsApp. I say, send the message. She send. If somebody send a comment, she will send it to me. I look. When I have time to answer, I answer. But I have my time too. I go to Facebook and check. If you are there to work, Father, I am working. Help me to finish my work. When you finish, pew. It's time to share your message. Holy Spirit, what do you want me to share? Don't just go like that. You open, what is that again? Eh? New revelation. Fake. That one. Don't mind that these people, you begin to talk anyhow. You begin to comment anyhow. You see this one, you know, spirit of hatred and enter, spirit of jealousy. You say, hey, look at that one. You don't even know why you enter Facebook. You just enter because people enter. You begin to do things. That is how you are dangerously distracted. You cannot say Jesus come at that hour, you make it. No. I am 100% sure. If Jesus come that hour, you will not even know. How will you hear the trumpet sound? When your hours, your times are just up and down, up and down, up and down. If I tell you tomorrow, what is your plan tomorrow? What time do you pray? Do you have any time? Do you have any time? The time has come, virtuous woman, please. Have a timetable. Have a timetable. Praise the Lord. Everything have its own time. Plan according to the remaining days. The Bible says perilous days. It says last days. Plan according to these last days. There's no more time. Plan. Make sure that you are secure forever, my dear sister. Do not joke again. Praise the Lord. Do not joke again. I want you to know that many of us have joined the wagon of the foolish, virtuous woman. You don't know that. Many of us have joined the wagon of the foolish virgin without even knowing. I'm not saying that you are not a virtuous woman. You are a virtuous woman, but the foolish one. Foolish one. Virtuous woman on Facebook, please. I'm not telling that I don't want virtuous women on Facebook. I'm not the one that will dictate your life. I'm not a dictator. After I preach like this, me myself, I'm going to take off my soul. Oh. You understand? I take off my soul. I finish, I say, God, I've preached. Thank you. As I'm preaching to myself. The wagon of, hey! Do you know that when you people are praying, I'm listening? Do you think that for me to listen, I have to come to Zoom? I have a way. After praying, the virtuous woman is there on the, I say, hey, I will ask Marie Vasco, what time is it now? Marie Vasco say, 1 hour. What is that? What are they talking again? And sometimes he's repeating the same word. How can Satan will not enter, virtuous woman? After prayer, praise the Lord, share the grace, go and sweep the house, go and clean up, the table is not shining, go and take tissue, shine it very well, praise the Lord. What is that talk, I say, do you know that we are laughing? I'm there laughing, I say, oh God, I will laugh, tears will come up from my eyes, I say, God, Jesus, these people are talking, what are they talking again? That's why I like Sister Glory Frank. She will just come at the end to say, you people, the way you people are comporting yourself, me myself that just come, you are this one is no more Christianity. She will come and say it the truth. Please, Sister Glory Frank, next time, when they begin to talk, close, say bye-bye. Leave them. Sister Grace, I don't want any meeting after prayer. After prayer, no more meeting. If it's something important, tell them like this. Ta-ta-ta-ta-ta, finish. Those long dragging, it will, that is distraction. Distraction. The remaining hours is too short, virtuous women. It's very, very, very short. Do a timetable. Do a timetable. I'm not, don't go and say, Sister Claire, forcing us. Like one that was saying that let us pay tithe for our 24 hours. It's for your own good. For your own good. At least, the day you have 24 hours, a day you pay 2 hours and 40 minutes. We want to make sure that on that day, before the throne of God, we are blameless. People say I'm forcing them. I say, it's not a law. It's not written in the Bible. I'm not forcing you people. You understand? But I'm just showing you the way. I'm showing you as a wise virgin has to comport herself. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. So many of us are foolish, virtuous women. Sorry to say that. Foolish, virtuous women in Christ. Many of us, we have brilliant testimony. If I call the virtuous women, everybody have encounter. All the virtuous women have encounter with Jesus. And that I know. It's true. But most of us are foolish because the oil is drying. And we don't even care to feel the oil. The oil is drying. Some people before, they don't respond anyhow. But today they respond. I was talking with my dad. My dad was saying that in the Christendom, the more people grow in the Lord, the more they become stubborn, the more the love of God become little. Let us not become that kind of Christian. Virtuous woman. The more you are growing in the Lord, the more become a virtuous woman. Don't just use that name. But we must see that the character of a virtuous woman in you. Are you a heavenly minded or dangerously distracted? Or do you, many virtuous women today as foolish virtuous women? Foolish virtuous women. I'm not saying that you are the one. I'm not saying that, sister, this one, you are the one. I'm saying many of us. You want the Holy Spirit to come and clink your ear, beat you for you to know that you are a foolish virtuous woman. If you want to know if you are a foolish virtuous woman, see the way you are spending your 24 hours daily. Tell me. Many virtuous women are run away because of prayer. They don't want prayer. It is time, when it's time to pray, that is the time Satan will now remind them that they have no cooks. Oh, they need to go and do shopping. Oh, there are witches in the virtuous woman. Witches. Eh? Witches, demon in the virtuous woman. Satan, they were not demon. Now that we are starting praying, demon came. Looking for a way to distract you so that you will not focus on your heaven. And then you'll be doing things. Some virtuous women, as we are praying, they are on Facebook. What are you doing on Facebook? I'm sharing the message. Which message? Share the message and leave it. What are you doing? That's why you... And Facebook is so dangerous, my sister. You don't know. It's very, very dangerous. If you are not careful, you will begin to watch pornography without even knowing. The porno movie that we are running away is live on Facebook. Be careful. Be careful. Be heavenly minded, not dangerously distracted. Praise the Lord. I want you to understand, I'm not rushing. We will go in the word of God. But I want you to know that this thing, the last days that we are running now, is so... Hey. Yes. My dear sister, beware. Be careful of the way you spend your daily life. The way you are wasting the remaining hours. See the way you are wasting the remaining days. 2015 has gone like the virtuous woman. What have we done? Truly, this ministry is a woman ministry. We are not men. We are too lazy. Let us wake up. I was telling sister that we cannot continue to be on Zoom like that. Every day, Zoom, Zoom. We are so relaxed. What kind of ministry is Zoom like that? Now, Zoom ministry. My ministry not be Zoom ministry. It's not Zoom ministry. It's to go prepare all the women all over the world. We are not Zoom. We are not God to meet you. We left God to meet you. We are not Zoom here. It's for a time. The day I will close this, go to meet, do Zoom. The day I will close this Zoom like that, it's going to be forever. I am telling you, I'm still giving you time. We need to wake up. See, the way we are wasting 2015, I just waste like that. But I'm sure that you have been busy doing your thing. But the things of God doesn't have any value. I'm a virtuous woman. How many virtuous women came yesterday? The limit is 50. It was so full that there is no more. You cannot enter again. I'm sure many people wanted to enter. There is no space anymore. You see? But when he came to do the right thing. Lord, have mercy upon us. The Lord have mercy upon us. We know that the time is up. We say the time is up. Yes, but you are dangerously distracted. You know time is up. Who unto you? You know that the times are dangerous, but you are still distracted. Who unto you, my sister? Who unto you? The way you are wasting your times like that. You are not even careful. You are so careless. You are so negligent. Your soul, just like that. See the way you spend your day, your 24 hours. What if Jesus come that time now? Who are you going to blame? Who are you going to blame? The Holy Spirit. Let us go back. Let us go back. Let us come back to our senses. We have been so much distracted. Don't allow the things of this earth take your mind away from the business of God. Hallelujah. God says in his word, watch. Watch. The time that we are going through is an hour that everybody should be watchful. We do not know the hour. We don't know the time. We don't know the year. Some people dream Jesus told them that he will come in winter. It's a lie. He will come in an hour that you don't know. I don't know. Watch. Don't let the enemy take over that business. Take over your mind. Take over your situation. That you forget that you are going to heaven. We are just passing by. We are traveling. It's like somebody taking a train. The journey is so long. And then they have to stop somewhere to buy oranges. But let me tell you, we have been traveling for many years. The journey was long, but now the journey is short. The journey is short now. It's no more long. Watch. The Lord knows that you have a big project to achieve. The Lord knows that you are getting married soon. You are getting your baby soon. You are having your great birthday next year. You know, you are graduating as a doctor next year. He knows that you are a Facebook minister. Through that Facebook, you have been winning a lot of souls. But he say, watch. Watch. Make sure that you are heavily minded in what you are doing for me. Praise the Lord. Amen. You are thinking too much of that business. and you forget that your time is up. You are forgetting that the time is up. You are so focused. Ah, I must get this. I must get that paper. I must fill this paper. I must do like this. 24 hours, your mind is in that thing. And you forget that time is up. What if you die at that moment? What if you die at that very moment where you don't expect? The Bible said that there is a time for everything. Yes. You can even focus your mind. Time to think about my project. From 10 to 12. From 12 to 14. Time to do this. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. When you begin to when the alarm ring, time to think about the project. Then you say, oh God, help me. You pray. Then you begin to think. As you are thinking, is that time that you are thinking? You know that you are heavily minded, but you are just focusing in the project. Hallelujah. Work like that, virtuous woman. Watch. There is time of everything. Plan ahead. In the time that your time will not be wasted. Don't be wasting your time. The remaining days here on earth. 2 hours to finish this project. 1 hour to watch this message. This one in the kitchen. Another hour to clean up the clothes, to iron the clothes, to go to my kitchen. Yes. Do you know what I'm doing now? I'm learning how to cook Irish food now. Yeah, I am. I have my time for it. Yes, every Friday, I have an Irish person that comes here around 11 and 1 and teach me how to cook Irish food. Yeah, you didn't know that. Yes, that is my time. It's an example I'm giving to you. So that, yes, my children, when they come back to school, I say, this one, I have a new food to cook for you guys. They say, what is it again, mommy? Yeah. Let us be balanced in everything. So that on that day, you'll be blameless. Every hour, every minute. Don't be, your time is just like chaka-chaka like that. You are 10 o'clock. You pray 10, you pray 11, you pray 12, you pray, even brush your teeth, you have not brushed your teeth, the pot are there, dirty, this one. Your husband will come and say, what is that? I don't want you to join this virtuous woman again. You don't know how to manage your time. Why are you blaspheming the name of God like that? I'm a minister. You're on Facebook, minister of God, Facebook. Since morning, you're on Facebook. What are you doing on Facebook? Because of you, they are insulting the virtuous women. Because of you, they will say your leader is the one teaching you. You see? We have to be very careful so that we are blameless in what we are, everything we are doing. Manage your time. 30 minutes for Facebook every day is okay. God is not against that. I'm not saying that off the Facebook. I'm not saying off the Facebook. But manage your time. Praise the Lord. Value your time. Be busy. Be busy with the things of God. Be busy with heaven. Many of us are busy with the secular things. The activities of, you know, and you have planned, you have made, put your alarm will ring. You know that at 5 o'clock, you have to be at the train station. Yes, you are busy. Some of us, we go for school for 4 years just to become a normal nurse. They will study. How much more your heaven? You know, you just have like remaining days. It might be 1 month, my dear sister. Times is up. It's up. Why not plan the way you are planning for your secular life, the secular things, the way you are planning? Some people will come, after a long walk, see, now I am graduated. Why not do the same for heaven? Work. Plan your time. your daily time, virtuous woman. Now we are going to turn to the book of Luke chapter 10. We are going to read the story of two women. Luke chapter 10 verse 38 to 42. I want a virtuous woman to read for us. Praise the Lord. Yeah, 38 to 42.
Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Luke chapter 10, verse 28 to 42.
38 to 42.
I read in Jesus' name. Now it came to pass as they went that he entered into a certain village, and a certain woman named Martha received him into her house. And she had a sister called Mary, which also sat at Jesus' feet and heard his word. But Martha was cumbering about much serving and came to him and said, Lord, doest thou not care that my sister has left me to serve alone? Bid her, therefore, that she help me. And Jesus answered and said unto her, Martha, Martha, thou art careful and troubled about many things, but one thing is needful, and Mary has chosen that good part, which shall not be taken away from her. Amen.
There is something the Lord wants us to learn here. Martha and Mary, two women. Jesus is visiting Martha. And Martha choose to go to welcome her visitors, which is very good. Virtuous woman is one of her character. It's good. If you come in my house, I will make sure I receive you very well. I will ask you, do you want tea? Do you want any drink? I have orange juice. I have apple juice. Do you want water? You know, are you hungry? Have you eaten? You know, I will go and do food for you. What she did was very good. But Jesus said, Martha, Martha, thou art careful and troubled about many things. One thing is needful, and Mary are choosing that good part, which shall not be taken away from her. Eh? Jesus wants us to know that the only thing that is important is life, is heaven. If the way you are planning your life, your daily life, Monday, put heaven before. Praise the Lord. Value the things of heaven. Martha knew that Jesus was coming. Why should you not prepare the food before? Why is when Jesus Christ is coming, then she will go to the kitchen, begin to check. I want to fry plantain. I want to fry fish. I want to do this. When it's time to listen to the word of God, many women here, when it's time to listen to the word of God, that is the time she have to go to the kitchen. I'm hearing, and you think I'm not hearing the noise? I'm hearing the pot. Blah, 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 blah. I'm hearing it. What were you doing before? What were you doing before? Certainly, maybe you were on Facebook. You were on Facebook or you were on Skype. You were talking on the phone. When it's time to pray now, then you remember, oh, my husband is coming very time. Now, let me go to kitchen. You see, Martha was doing something good, but in the wrong time. Manage your time, virtuous woman. It is because you are dangerously distracted that you are mixing things. You are doing things up and down. Your time is not well planned. Your time is not organized. Somebody will call you. Let's do this. You just go. Oh, yeah, I'm here. I'm available. I'm available. I'm available. That's why we don't know whether you are a foolish virtuous woman or you are a wise virtuous woman. Let me tell you, I need to divide today. There are two kinds of virtuous women: foolish virtuous women and wise virtuous women. Are you a foolish one? The foolish one will be dangerously distracted. They are dangerously distracted. 24 hours on Facebook. Oh, la, 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 la. My Facebook is open, but I'm not there. And Marie Vashko, when she go on Facebook, is to share the message. And then she take the comment. She send it to me. Me too, I send it to her. Praise the Lord. I have alarm on my phone. Time for Facebook. The alarm ring, bang! I go on Facebook. I'm telling you what I'm doing now. Do it like me. Praise the Lord. Time for Facebook, bang! You go on Facebook. You open your, you pray, Father, I'm going to open the Facebook. Holy Spirit, lead me. Let it be as an habit. The way when you go out, you pray. Because you don't know what will happen tomorrow, outside. Same time when you open your YouTube, you open your Facebook, pray. Let it be an habit because Satan is waiting for you on Facebook to attack you. People don't even like me. They don't like my face. Especially when they know that I'm there. If Sister K is dead, because I just run away. I said, thank you. I will just run away. I said, hey. You understand? Be careful. Yes. Be careful. Matter. That are careful and trouble of many things. But one thing is needful. Mary has chosen the good part. We shall not be taken away from her. When you choose eternity, heaven, it will not be taken away from you. Praise the Lord. You know, there's one woman who called me. She said, a virtuous woman is only when you care about the things of your home. Take care of your husband. No. A woman asked me a question. Will you serve God and will you take care of your home? I said, I will do the two of them. Praise the Lord. I will do the two of them. Matt was that kind of woman that just take off the things of the house, you know. And Mary, because Jesus says she has chosen the good part, I'm sure that Mary was that organized woman. Praise the Lord. Be organized, virtuous woman. Before you even pray and come and pray with us, that is why we're giving you time. You have this and this and this time. Between this hour, make sure that your husband will not say you are spending time on Facebook when the children are not bathed. Children, you cannot clean them. They are dirty. And then say you are waiting for heaven. Which heaven you are waiting? Which heaven you are waiting? When in your home, your husband is accusing you for not taking care of the children, you need to be blameless. Praise the Lord. So when it's time to pray, make sure that you have already prepared the food. Your husband will come. Amen. It's just time to prepare the table, everything, and sit down and eat with him. Praise the Lord. Your plan, you have to plan your daily life. Martha chose to do the cooking. They do the cook in the kitchen at the wrong time. When it was time to listen to the word of God, she was busy in the kitchen. She did not know that. She knew that people are coming. She knew. She could have prepared. Then when she finished to hear the word of God, then she said, let me warm the food. Yes. Now we're in the modern ways. We can just go to the microwave. Just warm the couscous, you know. Yes. One day, a pastor came to my house. He was coming to my house. They called me. They said, we are coming. And I know that they are coming for a long journey. That day, I did couscous and I did semolina very well. And when you do the couscous, you wrap it in the, you know, that flink paper, that paper, that transparent. Yes, I'm giving you now a very, very good view that doesn't know. When you do couscous, to make it very nice, you know that plastic paper, wrap it inside and keep it there. When you want to warm it, just take, you warm it. The pastor came and warmed it. It was like fresh. He ate it. The wife ate it. They were so happy. And when he came, we were sharing the word of God together. You know? We shared the word of God. He told me his experience, you know? How the Lord has been using him. How the Lord has been using them. We prayed. We were happy. Then as we were doing it, we were in the kitchen eating. That is what Jesus could have been eating the food. Why is there? You understand? Somebody can be eating the food. Why is hearing the word of God? That is what Martha missed. She was in the kitchen, busy with the things of God, busy with the things of the earthly things, instead to be heavenly minded. Don't allow what you are doing take away heaven from you. Take away your focus from heaven. Do you understand what I mean? Your cooking in the kitchen can be your distraction. Your children can be your distraction. It is not only Facebook. Somebody can be on Facebook, but it's not distracted. And you that close your account on Facebook, you are distracted the whole day. You understand what I mean? Eh? So make sure that the cooking, the kitchen that you do every day, it is not your, it's not a distraction. There is everything have its time. Time to go to bed early and wake up early and pray and then do your devotion. You prepare your children, you go to school on time, you come back, then you are there on time, everything on time, everything on time, daily. That's why God gave us 24 hours. It's enough to plan our daily life and to be ready at all time, heavily minded. Stop being dangerously distracted. Mm-hmm. Somebody can say, okay, I have too many children to take care of. Yes. You're taking care of your children can be a distraction when you do things in the wrong time. You have too many children. Plan with your children. Hallelujah. If you have too many children, your problem is finished now. This one will do this. This one will do this. This one will do this. They will help you. They will help you. Me, I have 3 kids. We plan our daily life together. If I have now 7, me, I don't have anything to worry now. Number 1 would help me to do this. This number 2 will help me to do this. This one will help me to do this. All as we are is doing and watching. I say, no, do like this, do like this. Children will come to even help you, you know, take away the burden. Yes. So why are you worried? Virtuous women, there's no more time to waste. Don't be saying, I have children. I have too many children. Things, how can I make heaven? You are, some people have headache. You are the cause of your headache. Any virtuous women who do not have a daily timetable will end up to be dangerously distracted. That virtuous woman can miss heaven easily. If you don't have a daily time, you just pray when the Holy Spirit, you know, just like when you are feeling. You read the Bible when you are feeling. Sometimes the Holy Spirit say, hey, when the last time you opened the Bible? Then you say, hey, yeah. Matthew. I will read Ezekiel. 2 Samuel. That's how many people does. Dangerously distracted. Let us be careful. Let us be careful, my sister. If somebody come attack you, you see the person is coming with evil ways, you know, be careful. Avoid that person. Avoid that person. You are not on Facebook to make friends. I tell you, you are there to evangelize. If somebody come now, let me tell you, maybe your home, you are using your home to preach the word of God, and somebody is coming to block, you know, you push the person away. You say, this is my home. You have your timetable. Don't allow backsliders to come and pollute the heart of other people. Facebook have a way that you can block people. Blocking somebody is not a sin. I want you to know that. It's not a sin. Blocking somebody that will come and pollute your wall. It's not a sin. You are just avoiding problem. You are avoiding trouble. You are there for a purpose. You are there to minister. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. Don't waste your time, virtuous woman. Please, I want you to take off your home. Take off your husband. When your husband come, remove the shoes. Place it very well. Kiss him. Honey, how are you? Welcome, my honey, my sugar, my tea, my butter. I don't know why you are calling him. You understand? When you finish like this, when it's time to pray, your husband will let you pray because you have already given him his time. But when your husband is there, you are there up and down. It is time you are in the kitchen. It is time you are here. He will say, hey, what kind of virtuous woman? Virtuous woman with name. I don't want our husband to give us a name. Oh, please. That's why when you say, my husband, we have conference, he will say no. He will say no. Because what are you learning? What are you showing him? But since the day I want, any virtuous will come and say, I came virtuous woman, my life has changed. It's a lie until your husband said you have changed. Let your husband testify that truly you are a virtuous woman. Yeah? We'll be having talk show. It's just that we don't have a studio. But in Nigeria, our journalist there, they'll be having talk show, inviting the virtuous woman husband to ask them, how are the virtuous women comporting themselves? Men have to come and say, yes, this one is truly a child of God. You're a virtuous woman, you don't even, your husband is smelling, the same shirt, the shirt is brown, hair is like this, you know, you don't iron the clothes, the husband is dirty. If your husband is dirty, you are the one that is dirty. Yeah? Take time, your time must be precious, virtuous woman. Your daily time, 24 hours, and we are living the last days, the perilous time. Amen. So I was saying that, please, for the people, minister on Facebook, don't spend time fighting with somebody. You tell the truth. Beware of backsliders. On Facebook, beware of, you know, stop fighting with backsliders on Facebook. You can't convince a backslider because he wants you the truth. It's only the Spirit of God. It's only the help of God. When somebody, the Holy Spirit will tell you somebody has backslided, run away from that person. If possible, block the person. Block the person. Yes. Don't pollute your mind. Don't pollute your heart. It is not a sin to block somebody when somebody is polluting your heart. Let me tell you that way. And you cannot, if somebody is calling you, it's not a sin not to answer. You are not, it's not an obligation to answer. If you know that call is not going to help your soul, don't pick it. Don't pick it. And you must have time where you are calling people. You can say from now, this hour to this hour, and let me just send some message in WhatsApp. Praise the Lord. How are you, my sister? Just checking on you. Hallelujah. Today I was meditating in God bless you. Bye. I have a message to share with you. Go on YouTube. Check this message. When you have time, check. God bless you. I love you. The Lord is your strength. It's very soon, very soon we are getting there. Hallelujah. I didn't say that because you are heavily minded. Now you will not greet your sister. I know. Time for everything. Praise the Lord. Amen. So be balanced in everything. Balance. All this talkative on Zoom, I don't want to hear it again. Please. Mommy Grace. Praise the Lord, virtuous woman. Oh, the program. When you finish dragging. You will drag. It becomes gossip. Do not allow women to run away from us. They say, we are coming to find Jesus. We'll come again. Another problem. Virtuous women, gossipers. Hey, I don't want to hear. Virtuous women are gossipers. We don't want to hear it, please. God forbid. That they will call us gossipers. Any virtuous woman that is gossipers, it's not a virtuous woman. No. It's a foolish virtuous woman. I want to let you know now today. If you know a virtuous woman, she says she's among the virtuous women, and she's gossiping, I want you to know that she is not a real virtuous woman. She's a foolish virtuous woman. Hallelujah. So let us learn how to manage our time. Amen. Preparing your heaven according, you have to let Jesus Christ enter your daily life every day. If Jesus come in the morning, you are raptured. Jesus come in the afternoon, you are raptured. Jesus come when you are cooking, you are raptured. You are in the bed with your husband, you are raptured. You are going to drop your children, you are raptured. You are on the phone, you are raptured. Because even when you are on the phone, that was the time to talk. And you know what you are talking. You are not doing things anyhow like that. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. So, Martha was busy in the kitchen preparing food for Jesus Christ. But Mary was sitting at the feet of Jesus Christ, listening to the precious word. Martha was doing something good, but at the wrong time. Today, we place more value on the things of the world. Many virtuous women today, they say they are busy. Look at what they are busy on. When you see what they are busy doing, it's just like what Martha was doing. Ask them, my sister, how many hours are you spending with God a day? How many? 30 minutes is too much, or 15 minutes is too much. But they will spend 20 hours with the things of this world. They place more value on the things of this world. That is why Jesus told Martha, Martha, Mary have chosen the good thing. I'm not telling you to go to not to go to school. No. Even when going to school, you have to manage your time. Make sure that Jesus can have the 24 hours in your school. You are there to study. When time the teacher enter, hello, hello, mathematics. Yes, you are focused on mathematics. After that, breaking time. Go and do your break. Don't be doing things like this. So, no. It is time to study. It's time to study. Break time. It's time to eat. It's time to eat. Then you can use maybe 5 minutes and pray. Be focused and be ready all the time, my sister. Yes. Some people don't, the things of God does not have value for them. One day somebody told me, and Sister Claire, the person know that God has called you. But the person says, Sister Claire, I think you need a job. You need a work. Go and do a work. I say, yeah, I have a job. I'm working. She said, no, I'm not talking about that one. I said, go and get a proper job. I said, is it because your job is different, the way that maybe you are getting salaries? Me, I don't get salaries. Me, I'm working. You get out in the morning, you take the bus, you go to work. Me, I get out the morning, I sit down, and I talk to God. I pray, I prepare things that God want me to prepare. I am telling you, one day I almost fell into the plan of the enemy. The enemy was telling me, you need to work. You are too much focused on the things of God. You need to work. I'm telling you, I don't know how I saw myself in front of school. Can you imagine? Too much thinking, my dear sister. I went in this school. I say, the woman said, what do you want? I say, I study nurse. I want to be a nurse. What should I do to be a nurse? She look at my paper. She said, You can start next month. If you want, I can put your name. Hey! Then I went back home. I began to cry. The Lord rebuked me. He rebuked me. Is it because of the worries of the earth, the things of this earth that you are worried? I was telling God, I said, God, it's going to be difficult for me to achieve this work that you have given to me. I need to go and work. When I work, then I will have some time just for this work. And then I'm focused. That is how sit and start. Before you do like this, the ministry, you are not focused again. You know? We have to be very, very careful. I'm talking to the ministers of God that God has called fully. It's not everybody that God has called fully. When God called me, he spoke to me clearly. He said, focus only on the work that I've called you. Praise the Lord. So for me going to look for a secular job, I'm disobeying the Lord. Praise the Lord. Now, why am I saying this is because somebody came to me and said, look for a job. Why the person said job? What it does not value the work of God. It does not value the work of God. There's somebody, one day I called somebody, I said, look, see the work of God that I'm doing. You are good in computer. Come and help me. You understand? I might not have salary to give you, but the little one God will give to us. Well, I'm going to pay you. The person knows, say, no, me and Maria, I need to take care of my family. The person went to work in the kind of job that I don't know. I say, hey, you understand? A job that I say, hey, Jesus, see, people don't put value on the things of God. You understand? Because the work of God, we only, you will not only enjoy the presence of God, you will all, even in heaven, great is your reward when you are doing the things of God. Please let us value heaven more than the things of this earth. Let us value heaven more than the things of this earth. Don't look at your project like it's everything to you and forget about heaven. You are so distracted. You are reading books. But the Bible, that is the word of God, you don't read the word of God. Praise the Lord. May the Lord help us in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. We are going to open 1 Corinthians chapter 3. 1 Corinthians chapter 3, verse 10 to 15. First Corinthians chapter 3, verse 10 to 15. According to the grace of God, which is given unto me as a wise master builder, I have laid the foundation and another build thereon. But let every man take heed how he build thereupon. For other foundation can no man lay than that is laid, which is Jesus Christ. Verse 12. Now, if any man build upon this foundation, gold, silver, precious stone, wood, hay, stubble, every man's work shall be made manifest. For the day shall declare it, because it shall be revealed by fire, and the fire shall try every man's work of what sort it is. Verse 14. If any man work abide which he hath built thereupon, he shall receive a reward. Verse 15. If any man's work shall be burned, he shall suffer loss, but he himself shall be saved, yet so as by fire. You understand? Now, how are you building your Christianity? Are you building it upon the foundation Jesus Christ? Or upon wood? Are you building your foundation upon the precious stone, which is Jesus Christ, or you are building it upon the wood? Because whatever works you are doing, you will pass through fire. The fire will try your works. And if your foundation was built upon the wood, the fire will burn it. That's why you see many virtuous women, foolish virtuous women, they fall today. They have gone astray. Why? Because the foundation was built upon the wood. The wood are the things of this life, the care of life, the secular life. They are so dangerously distracted with the things of this world. They are not heavenly minded. Somebody that is heavenly minded is someone, is that sister, is that virtuous woman that have built a foundation upon the rock, upon the precious stone, upon gold, Jesus Christ. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Don't fill your life, your daily life, with secular things. Your daily life must be heavenly. You are a heavenly citizen. Your passport, the stamp of in that passport is heavenly citizen. You are not a British citizen. You are not a Irish. You are not a Cameroonian. You are a heavenly citizen. You are on your way to heaven. Therefore, how do you spend your daily life? Your foundation, is it built upon the rock, upon the precious stone, or upon the wood? Because one day you will be standing before the throne of God. Jesus, the fire will begin to try your works. Praise the Lord. Let us be careful. Let heaven be impact your daily life every day. Don't fill your life with secular things. Let all you are doing, your doings, your work, your project, follow the agenda of God. Hallelujah. In your busy life, take an eternal view in your busy life. Be heavenly minded in your busy life. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Take away what need to be taken away. Any wood, begin to remove. Check your foundation, the foundation of your life. How will you check your foundation of life? Begin to examine your life. How do you spend your daily life? These things that has more value in your life, those are the things that you spend more times on it. Because you can say that Jesus have more value in your life, but you spend less time with Jesus. That is how you will know that your foundation is not upon Jesus, because you are not spending the things, your things that you are doing are not is not the things of somebody that is heavenly minded. Praise the Lord. So begin to remove all these things in your foundation, these things that are distracting you. Remove them. Take them away. Take them away. Don't build your life. Many people build on life, their life up, on philosophies, institutions, doctrines of men, Yeah, that is how they build their life. All those things are wood. They will pass away. When trial will come, any virtuous woman that builds her life, you know, on philosophies, the way they think, the things of men, the way they respond, the way they act, you see that the foundation is not built on the word of God. The foundation is not built on the rock. It's not built on the precious stone. The foundation is built on the wood. That is why when trial come, fire come, they will begin to fall. They will begin to fall. The fire is the time of is that time of trials to try your faith, and you begin to fall. Why? Because you are not heavenly minded. You are busy on the things of the earth. Your foundation is built on wood, not on the solid rock. The Bible says that every man's work shall be manifest. Shall be manifest. We will know if your foundation is built upon the rock. We will know if you are heavenly minded or you are dangerously distracted. Your daily life will determine whether your works in your daily life will determine whether you are heavenly minded or dangerously distracted. You are busy on the things that are not heavenly activities. You are busy on the things that will pass away. Your mind. Somebody can be busy working, you know, on this in the secular life, but is heavenly minded. Please, I hope you are getting what I'm telling you. Praise the Lord. When the fire will try your work, you who build your life on the wood, you will not resist that fire. You will fall. Because instead of building your life on the rock, you build your life on the wood. You build your life on your degrees. Your life was, I must be like this, I must be like that. Every day you are thinking of all, you are talking about it, you are thinking about it, you don't even sleep. But what about your heaven? What about your heaven, my sister? Don't lay your foundation on materials, perishable things. Build your life on Jesus, not corrupt things. But Jesus, build your life on the word of God that will never pass away. That is what Jesus Christ was trying to tell Martha, do like Mary. Build your life on the word of God that will never be taken away from you. Praise the Lord. Now, I'm going to finish by telling you, my dear sister, begin to examine your daily life. Begin to examine your daily life. Is your daily life filled with the things of God? Is your daily life filled with the things that will pass away or the things that will last forever? Examine your life. As I'm talking, some people are checking other things. They are not heavenly minded. You are doing activities, but you are dangerously distracted. You see? You see your problem? You are Martha. Martha. Martha! Do like Mary. Do like Mary. Time is up. Time is very short. The journey is short. A sister told me, Sister Claire, the journey is short. We are almost there. We are almost there. Wake up. Plan. Have a timetable. Examine your life. Examine your life. Remove all this wood. Remove all this things that are distracting you. Remove them from your life. Remove them, my sister. Remove them. Put them aside. They are not necessary. Replace them. Replace them with the eternal activities. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Replace them with the things of God. Take away the wood. Take away the wood in your foundation. Replace it with the gold, with the rock, the precious stones, according to this 1 Corinthians chapter 3 we just read. Replace it with Jesus. Hallelujah. Things that will not perish. Many virtuous women have backslidden because of the wrong foundation. Praise the Lord. They've built their foundation on wood. When the fire came to try them, they all collapsed. Don't be that virtuous woman. Don't be that foolish virtuous woman. Hallelujah. Be devoted with the eternal activities. your daily life in your kitchen, be focused on heaven. When Jesus called you, you just lift up your head and then you go. Praise the Lord. Stop being distracted. Don't be busy for God and be distracted. Be busy for God and be heavily minded. Go to school, but be heavily minded. Go to work, but be heavily minded. Plan your project, but be heavily minded. Let Jesus Christ be number one in your life. Do not allow any situation to come and take you away from God. Do not allow any news to come and take your mind away from God. Anything they tell you, praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Be focused. Stand still. Don't look right. Don't look left. Don't look back. Don't shake. Praise the Lord. Stand still. Teach the good path like Mary. Be focused. Be focused on the eternal things. Let your heart, let your talent, let your project, let your vision, let all that you are planning be used for the glory of God. That was the word of God today. I know it's painful to remove all those things that we used to love. You know, some women, like I heard yesterday, some women lack action. Now, time of action has gone. Now you need to be disciplined. Discipline. Be focused. Be focused on your spiritual life. You are a traveler. You are going somewhere to that city. Time now, the time of break has gone. Let us enter into the wagon. Hallelujah. The train. Let's go. I know the fun, sin is fun. People love sin. Sin is very fun. Pleasure is fun. Worldly things are fun. But it's time to remove all this fun, all these funny things in our life. Praise the Lord. It's better not to have fun here on earth and make heaven than to have fun here on earth and go to hell and suffer sorrow, pain forever. Hallelujah. So, one thing I want to tell you today, do away from anything that distracts you today. Do away from anything that distracts you. All these things that are distracting you, replace it with God. Replace it with God. Don't let them take away your mind. Even when you are working on that project, don't let the project take your mind away from God. Praise the Lord. Satan has released a spirit of distraction upon the children of God. In the mighty name of Jesus, may the Lord deliver you. May the Lord bring you, break every chain of distraction in the mighty name of Jesus. Be focused. We are living the remaining days. These remaining days, the remaining hour, don't waste it. Don't waste it. Work harder. Hallelujah. Wake up, my sister. Wake up. Don't sleep again. The Lord has opened my mouth to tell you today this truth. He that has an ear, let him hear. Don't be like Mary. Don't be like Matt. Sorry, be like Mary. Choose the good path. May the Lord have impact in all your daily life. In your kitchen, Jesus have the first place. In your home, in your bed, Jesus have the first place. In your project, in your tomorrow, Jesus have your first place. If you continue to live like that, I pray you will not miss heaven in the mighty name of Jesus. Be heavenly minded. Don't be dangerously distracted. In the name of Jesus. That was the word of God of today. And we are going to pray. We are going to pray. You are going to say, oh Lord, help me. Take away every distraction from my life. And then after that, we'll hand I will ask Sister Marie Vashko to give us 3 prayer points. And then after that, I will pray for you. Open your mouth, begin to say, my Lord, God, my Father, help me. Help me, Lord. Take away every distraction in my life. Help me to be focused in the mighty name of Jesus. Open your mouth, begin to pray. My Lord God, my Father, help me to be focused, O Lord, in the mighty name of Jesus.